Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 8 topics to cover, so let's get started. As announced at Google Cloud Next, apps can now get, list, and subscribe to Google Chat events. To receive events, your app can do either of the following: subscribe to events using the Google Workspace Events API, and receive events as they occur using Google Cloud PubSub. Query for space events by calling the chat API. Both APIs support and deliver the same event types. Here an overview to understand whether you should subscribe to or query for events. We will soon release a video where we cover how to subscribe to Google Chat events in detail. You can now get and update a user's read state in a space and get a user's read state in a message thread. User read states are singleton resources that represent details about a specified user's last read message. On screen, you see an example of how you can get a space read state, update a space read state, and get a thread read space. Your chat app can now send an app home cart message to a user. This message is a customizable cart message that a chat app can send to a user when they open a direct message with the chat app. As you can see on screen, you can configure the app home cart message to include tips for interacting with the chat app, dynamic information, and actions. You can make the app home available to end users by enabling a chat app's direct message. You can now update a human user's membership in a chat space to change their role between regular member and space manager. To do so, you can use the patch method on the membership resource of the Google Chat API. On screen, you see an example of making a regular space member a space manager by specifying role as role manager. Google Chat apps now support Google AppScript's card service. If you've built your chat app using AppScript, you can either use card service or JSON to build user interfaces such as card messages and dialogues. There are 2 new methods for AppScript spreadsheet service that have been added to multiple classes. The cancelDataRefresh method cancels the data refresh associated with the object it's called on if the refresh is currently running. On screen, you see the classes that this method has been added to. The cancelAllLinkedDataSourceObjectRefreshes method has been added to the DataSource class. This method cancels all currently running refreshes of data source objects linked to the data source this method is called on. You can now import a space from other messaging platforms and allow external users to join that space. This feature is available through the Developer Preview Program. The Dialogflow CX in Google Chat API has graduated from the Developer Preview Program and is now generally available. Check out the comprehensive tutorial and code sample showing how to build a chat app that understands and responds with natural language using a direct integration between Dialogflow CX and Google Chat API. We've added the link to the tutorial in the description for this video and invite you to try it out. Let us know in the comments section below. Do you plan to use any of these new features? Make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you stay up to date with all things Google Workspace platform related.